नमस्कार, स्वागत है आपका हमारी खास पेशकश पूर्वोत्तर के सितारे में। मैं हूं संजीव श्रीवास्तव। जैसा कि आपको मालूम ही है, इस कार्यक्रम में हर सप्ताह हम आपका परिचय कराते हैं पूर्वोत्तर की किसी विशिष्ट हस्ती से, किसी ऐसी शख्सियत से या किसी ऐसी संस्था से आपकी मुलाकात करवाते हैं जिन्होंने अपने काम, मेहनत और इच्छा शक्ति के बल पर समाज में कुछ ऐसा करके दिखाया है कि वह बन गए हैं आसपास के लोगों के लिए एक प्रेरणा स्रोत। इसी कड़ी में आज हम आपको मिलवाएंगे आर के पॉल से, जो आते हैं नागालैंड से लेकिन बस गए हैं अरुणाचल प्रदेश के एक दूर दराज इलाके में और काम कर रहे हैं डिफरेंट स्फीयर्स में। चाइल्ड राइट्स की दुनिया में वो सक्रिय हैं, विमेन एम्पावरमेंट के लिए वो काम कर रहे हैं, शिक्षा और रोजगार कैसे ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा लोगों को मिल सके इस दिशा में भी प्रयासरत। पॉल साहब, बहुत शुक्रिया हमारे लिए समय निकालने के लिए और हमसे बातचीत करने के लिए। तो सबसे पहले तो दिमाग में एक सवाल यही आता है कि आप हैं नागालैंड के और अपनी कर्म भूमि आपने बना रखी है अरुणाचल प्रदेश, इसके पीछे क्या राज है?
आई बेसिकली बिलोंग फ्रॉम अ विलेज कॉल ओकलोंग एंड देन यू नो फ्रॉम द चाइल्डहुड ऑनवर्ड्स माई पेरेंट्स दे आर इलिटरेट एंड दे आर बेसिकली फार्मर्स and we were blessed with six of us, three sisters and three brothers, you know. And then as I grew up in my family, I happened to be the youngest in my family. And well, my elder brothers and sisters, unfortunately, since parents were illiterate, you know, financially not well off, so they could not reach their destinations of even graduating. Not a single one of them graduated, and that has been in my mind also. I did struggled initial stages, small amount of help I received from my elders, but then after having crossed my matriculation and my 12th graduation, it was the manner which I put in, and then I said, like, if all my elders, brothers and sisters could not achieve anything in life, I need to do something at least to help them out. But then, unfortunately, before I could, do something in my life, my dad expired in 2009 and my mom expired in 2002 at a very premature ages. 2 years I stayed in Chennai, you know, to pay off my rent and pay off my tuition fee. Since I'm not getting any help from the home, I used to go every evening, all after my fieldwork and after my classes, I used to go every evening to southern part of Chennai to take tuition for the Koreans. And the Koreans who are employed in different companies there, I used to take tuition, English tuition to the parents and then even to the kids. That's how I was getting some amount and then surviving myself. In the first year, I was working with Action Aid, and then I worked for the pavement dwellers, transgenders. And then second year, I worked as a part of the fieldwork with World Vision, with the female sex workers, HIV AIDS. And these are the experiences which really gave an insight that, you know, beyond your comfort zone, there are humanity who are in different needs. And that was the base on which I launched off to work for the people who are in need. Arunachal being a place where it is much more cooler and then peaceful as compared to Nagaland and Manipur. You know, over there, even if you do something or the other, always there are people who are behind you as to follow you, and then even exhortation, all that comes about, not understanding what he or she does for humanity. So this has been one of the factors that, well, I prefer working in an area where there are more peaceful, where there are less disturbance, and where there are more human who are in real need.
सोशल वर्क में जाने की सबसे पहले कैसे सोची कि उस सब्जेक्ट में पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन करेंगे, क्योंकि दिमाग में ये नहीं आया कुछ और पढ़ के कोई एग्जाम दे के सरकारी नौकरी कर लें?
1997-98 I had an exposure of visiting few villages in eastern part of Arunachal and somehow being with missionaries for my past schooling days that inspired me like no money is not everything job is not everything I said where I am interested where my passion goes there I am happy so like working in a social sector like NGO running an NGO is nevertheless easy to work but then at the same time although I'm not getting any profit out of it whenever I go to the villages the smile I see in the face of children kids the smile I see in women who are really discriminated and undergoing hardships because of different factors the farmers who are toiling day in day out in the heat and rain and I look myself from different perspective altogether that being with them be able to give them a small joy or say a smile that's the ultimate aim which I looked at and that gives me a lot of satisfaction and happiness
aur aapki ye jo sanstha hai amiya iski shuruaat kaise hui aur kab hui
actually the organization called this amiya was registered by my missus herself before I came to know her or before I got married with her I found this paper documents just a single paper a registration certificate it clicks my interest I did my master in social work and so I dusted off the dust from the paper document and then I started working although it was registered in 2002 I started working in 2008 after making all the legal documents
so which was the first sector which you and Amiya identified to start your work with
I first approached NABARD based in Itanagar and I said any projects available where NGOs are eligible where I could apply and the then general manager and the staff were so good they said if you are genuine about your work and if you have got proper documentation you can apply for it so the first work began with SSG formation self-help groups in that locality in Changlang district where I began my work I said that you know I need to go to the villages I need to understand the feelings of the people the needs of the people interact with them discuss with them and the start of the SSG formation itself started with so called PRA participatory rural appraisal there are the various tools where we apply where we assess their wealth where we assess their natural and social wealth where we assess their assets problems situations everything is being assessed through that and that is the start of the program from that findings I come to the conclusion that really these are the needs which we need to attend to that's how our planning begins
kitni mahilaye is movement ke sath judi hain aapke self help groups kitne hain kahan kahan hain where all are they operating
my target areas are mainly in three districts of eastern Arunachal Pradesh one is Changlang the other is lower dibang valley and dibang valley and all these three projects are like supported in a very minimal way by the NABARD and in Changlang I have got 99 SSGs several groups till date and each member consisting of 10 to 15 and when it comes to lower dibang valley I have got 58 SSGs formed till date and again each member consisting of 10 to 15 and dibang valley that also was promoted under the project called the most backward districts in India that time when I got MOU signed it was one among the 25 most backward districts in that district I have formed 30 of them SSGs the women when you look at 5-6 years back who can't even articulate a word among themselves today they can like few of them have contested panchayat elections and they have come up and they are now few of them are like ASM few of them are like gram panchayat leaders so in different aspects women they have really come out of themselves from the four walls of their homes even to take up food processing units in a small way even to start going to the field as a group cultivate ginger when you look at the lower dibang valley district where my office is located they have even formed a SSG federation at district level it initially started from primary federation at the village level cluster at the block level and now they are into district level federation these women body they are very strong not only in profit making or income generation, but even social sector, like working against antisocial elements in the society, trying to campaign and work against drugs abuse, substance abuse, opium cultivation, all that.
Farmers ke bhi aapne groups banaye, farmers cooperatives wagera, wo bhi in tino zilo mein hai?
They are basically in two districts, and these two again supported by NABARD. And in Chalang district, I've got 20 farmer clubs formed last year. And then in Lower Dibang Valley, we have formed 15 farmer clubs. Through these farmer clubs, we are trying to introduce a new concept called use of application of technology, and then applying credit loan from banks, where the manpower will be reduced, technology will come in, they will have, within a short time, they will have more work done in the field, production will be more. And then we're looking even in the aspect of able to market these products. Till date, marketing has been always a bottleneck in our area. Chris Rin scheme has been launched by our Honorable CM of Arunachal Pradesh. So we're trying to encourage them to take all these loans and then try to make the maximum use of the land so that they get the maximum product out of it. And then on that market linkage problem, we, NABARD, district administration, and the government, we are trying to work out somehow and then give them just earning.
जब से अमिया एनजीओ का आर के पॉल सर है वो हम लोग को बहुत हेल्प किए हैं इसलिए हम लोग दुकान खोला है उससे पहले हम लोग घर में बैठ के पिकल्स हो गया जैसे कि मेखला गले मेखला हो गया कोट हो गया हर चीज़ जैसे कि हम लोग का हस्बैंड लोग क्या क्या कुछ कुछ सामान टोकरी हो गया बास्केट सब हो गया वो सब जो बनाते हो घर से बना के हम लोग इधर उधर बस्ती बस्ती या ग्रुप का दो तीन चार मिल के हम लोग ग्रुप जाके वो बेचता है बस्ती में ना तो उसमें हम लोग को इतना प्रॉफिट नहीं मिलता था अभी हम लोग को वही अमिया एनजीओ का उसका तरफ से हम लोग को बहुत फ़ायदा हो रहा है पहले तो सर हम लोग मतलब घर पे रहते थे जो ये घर में बना के कस्टमर को ढूंढने जाते थे बाहर पे तो ये अमिया एनजीओ से हम लोग को मिला है पोल सर से तब सर ने हम लोग को ये आइडिया दिया बहुत हेल्प किया एक दुकान खोलने के लिए तो एक दुकान खोल के हम लोग को मटेरियल्स का थोड़ा मदद किया तो सब बना के वीविंग करते हैं हम सब औरत बैठे घर में उसके बाद हम लोग ने एक छोटा सा दुकान लिया दुकान पे रख के अभी हम हर महीना एक औरत एक महीना बैठते हैं दुकान में तो उसको एक औरत को हम लोग 3000 देते सैलरी उसी से वो आराम से अपना बच्चा का ट्यूशन हो गया घर में कुछ कुछ सॉल्व हो जाता है
अमिया एनजीओ की तरफ से बहुत सारे फैसिलिटी मिले हम कोई बनाना मिला है रेके नाट और ट्यूबवेल रोड कॉलबर्ट ये सब वगैरह सब बहुत फैसिलिटी मिला है पहले से हम लोग बहुत आगे बढ़ चुका है डेवलप हुआ है हम लोग का बस्ती पहले से
हम लोग अमिया एनजीओ का अंदर में है हम लोग का ग्रुप फोर्सा एसएचजी है तो उसमें हम लोगों को नारकम का तरफ से थोड़ा मदद हो जाता है वहाँ से पैसा रिवॉल्विंग फंड डाल देते हैं हम लोग के लिए तो उसमें हम लोग लोन सिस्टम करके वो इंटरेस्ट में देते हैं पैसा ताकि बस्ती वालों को थोड़ा हम लोग को थोड़ा मदद मिले
अमिया ये एनजीओ प्रोजेक्ट जो आके ना हम लोग को जो पहले में घर में बैठे बैठे कुछ काम नहीं मिलता था अभी ये आके हम लोग को जो वेविंग का थोड़ा काम मिल गया अभी पैसा कमाने के लिए भी मौका मिला है
ट्रेनिंग लिया है मशीन की ट्रेनिंग दिया है तो उससे हम लोग को बहुत फ़ायदा हुआ है काम मिला है तो पहले बेकार थे घर में अभी काम मिला है
इन माई एरिया सिंस द पेरेंट्स आर नॉट सो मच एजुकेटेड नॉट कॉन्शियस ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ एजुकेशन इवन द किड्स देमसेल्फ्स ऑल आर इजी गोइंग यूथ बिकॉज ऑफ दिस फैक्टर इंक्रीजिंग अनएम्प्लॉयड यूथ एंड स्कूल ड्रॉप आउट दिस हैज लेड टू लॉट ऑफ इशूज इन द सोसाइटी प्रॉब्लम्स इन द सोसाइटी यूथ स्टार्टेड लूटिंग अराउंड दे स्टार्टेड यू नो गेटिंग एडिक्टेड टू ड्रग्स and substance abuse and this has really disturbed and this was what made me to think of looking out for some agencies where they could help me in training them giving them soft skills giving some sort of employability skills and I approached the so-called organization based in Bangalore that is NGO itself Quest Alliance based in Bangalore when I approached and they told me to give data, a sort of a survey report. And I gave, and that clicked their mind, they were interested. and they sanctioned for one pilot year's project. Last year was the project. And the name of the project is Skills to Succeed. It's basically exchanges program, but then implemented through Quest Alliance. So basically it was a certificate course of 3 months. And we taught them certificate course in hospitality and then retail management. Basically, these were the two trades. Whomever have trained last year, 410, they, now they are placed in majority of them are self-employed. Even taking up orange cultivation, large garden cultivation, having a petty shops, and very few have gone out of the states. And I look forward to training more youth, not only in based in rowing area, but in all Arunachal as a state. We are also engaged in child rights. There are a lot of cases where I have come across teenagers below 13 were raped by adults. You know, the report and cases were filed in the police station. There is no follow-up. And if the victim happened to be from a poorer, financially poorer families, and that they, he or she, the family members failed to file, counter-file a case against the culprit. And these things are very happening very much there. And when I speak of this child rights, I'm not speaking of only those extreme cases where child are victimized to rape, child are victimized to violation and death. But in my area, I think nowhere else it is happening. Among the teenagers from at the age of 13 to 20 or 25, my area is the highest teenagers committing suicides. So these are factors where we are trying to involve in and participate to, so as to at least save one life in a year. That would have been a great achievement.
You have rightly identified that education is the key to emancipation of every kind, really. You know, agar sach mein uddhar hona hai, to shiksha ke zariye hi ho sakta hai.
With my association with Quest Alliance, Quest Alliance is not about not only about skill development, but also they are working in the, into the field of education. And number of times I have attended workshops and then seminars organized by them. And when I look at how they are doing their work in Bihar, in association with Bihar government in Samastipur, they have introduced a concept called Anansala. So this Anansala is something where they keep the students engaged in the school. The activities which they implement through Anansala attracts the students to, in the school, and then keeps them that school is something where there is fun in learning, joy in learning. But this is missing in our state. Intervention in the government sector through PPP model, or say even not, even if they don't want to work with us in PPP model, at least to give us an opportunity to intervene and then implement some of what I think it will be applicable to reduce the school dropouts, to attract the students to school, and then to at least upscale the performance of the school. Right now, teachers are only into that primitive and traditional way of teaching, just on the contextual context textbook. But then I think we are in the 21st century where there are ample of opportunities for us to use technology so that the learning process becomes a blended one where all the senses are being stimulated, and then the kids, students love learning, and then they find a purpose of learning.
Amaya, is there anything else that you are working on? Bhavishya ki koi aur yojana?
This year only on 22nd of April, I initiated a voluntary group called I Clean Rowing. You know, it's under the big banner of Swachh Bharat, launched by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji. You know, this I got an inspiration through my conversation with my colleagues, or say friend, good friend. His name is Sunis, P.S. Sunis from Kerala, but he's working as PRO in NSPC office based at Rowing. And you know, having I always like people, speaking to people who are like-minded, whose interests are similar. And off and on, we have been meeting, chatting in his office, in my office. And the work that I Clean Bhopal began, it is amazing. And the photos they upload in social media before and after. So somehow inspiration came from there. I think getting inspired it's not a bad idea from anywhere. So we started, or say I initiated this I clean drawing in drawing, looking at the mismanagement of garbage in spite of Duda being there, in spite of, you know, all good people who are supposed to clear the garbages are there. So even in drawing proper town market, the dustbin are filled, spilled over, spreading across road, the garbage, amount of garbage. I said, I'll invite at least 4 or 5 women. I said, women will be in the front, will give just idea and push them from behind. Of course, we were there all throughout, even in terms of participation. So we gave them idea, let's begin. Let's begin with zero investment. We will not at all handle money, but we'll come every weekend, every Saturday from 6:30 to 7:30, give just 1 hour. We'll come together, clean up a spot fixing area. Not much. Our main goal is not to kachra ko pura safai karne ka hum log ka kaam nahi hoga. Lekin we'll come together for 1 hour, work together, along with that spread the news that we should stop littering our township, so that our main goal has been like, let's keep our rowing town green and clean. So we began with that. The work we began has inspired people from other districts. Now, Anini is another district, Dibang Valley. There, the youth who were with us in initial stages at drawing started I Clean Anini. And then similar work already began in another district called Lohit District, Teju. And just last Saturday, so we came, in spite of the rain, we came together. And then there's a lot of fun. We know that cleaning a garbage which has been stored for 2-3 months, and then you see the stinging worms and then rotten things, but still we coming together and then trying to clear out has got a lot of meaning to that. And good wishers, admirers, and then many people sponsored jersey for us, so that we have got a common logo, common tag name, I Clean Drawing. And then people started sponsoring, like, you know, snacks, chai. And then that's how we began, like, you know, that's so much of beauty. And then this activity of ours, I Clean, is catching up. And then number has increased. And district administration, the local MLA, people are really happy about the activity which we began.
बहुत अच्छा लगा पॉल साहब आपसे बात करके, और कितने अलग अलग क्षेत्रों में आप सक्रिय रूप से हस्तक्षेप कर रहे हैं, पहल कर रहे हैं, स्वच्छ भारत से लेके महिलाओं के सशक्तिकरण तक, फार्मर्स और किसान कैसे ज़्यादा अपने पाँव पर खड़े हो सकें, उसके साथ साथ युवा शक्ति भारत की कैसे सही दिशा में प्रेरित हो, सभी क्षेत्रों में आप काम कर रहे हैं, बहुत अच्छा लगा। और हमारी शुभकामनाएं आपके साथ हैं, अमिया के साथ हैं, कि आप आने वाले सालों में इसी ऊर्जा के साथ, इसी डेडिकेशन के साथ इस काम में लगे रहें। बहुत शुक्रिया।
थैंक यू।
तो ये थी मुलाकात आर के पॉल साहब के साथ, जो अरुणाचल प्रदेश के एक दूर दराज इलाके में एक संस्था चला रहे हैं जिसका नाम है अमिया। सुना आपने कितने अलग अलग क्षेत्रों में ये संस्था सक्रिय है। ऐसा नहीं है कि इसके पास करोड़ों अरबों रुपए का फंड है या कोई बहुत बड़ी विशाल ब्यूरोक्रेटिक संस्था है, बिल्कुल नहीं। लेकिन छोटी सी संस्था है, लेकिन कितने सकारात्मक, पॉजिटिव और सक्रिय हस्तक्षेप हैं इसके समाज के हर पहलू और हर वर्ग से जुड़े हुए। स्वच्छ भारत से महिला सशक्तिकरण, युवा शक्ति से किसान शक्ति तक, हर क्षेत्र में ये सक्रिय हैं। तो कैसी लगी आपको हमारी आज की ये पेशकश, बताइएगा ज़रूर। और इसके साथ ही मैं संजीव श्रीवास्तव अनुमति लेता हूँ आपसे। नमस्कार।